We now have Tommy Tallarico of Video Games Live.
Where is he? Oh, wait, that's me.
How do you find KO?
You know, I just got here late last night, I'm really looking forward. After I'm done with your interview, actually, I'm gonna go do some shopping. I want to go to the night market tonight.
Darling Street.
Maybe get some fake Rolexes. Tomorrow morning, I actually have a trip planned where I'm going to these caves.
Butter caves.
Yeah, where all the monkeys are. I love
monkeys. Beware of the monkeys.
Beware of the monkeys?
Seriously, like.
But I'm like a monkey myself, so I'm gonna fit right in.
They will go right up to your can, even if you're like holding it.
Yeah.
Coca-Cola, 100
plus. They'll take it. Oh, see, I'm gonna bring all the food I want. Then I want monkeys all over me. You know, it's like Planet of the Apes up in here.
Today we have Jack Wall from Video Games Live. We'll be talking to him about Video Games Live, which is coming to KL this weekend. So, yeah, you guys started in 2002, right?
We started planning in 2002. We did our first show July 6, 2005 at the world-famous Hollywood Bowl in Los Angeles,
11,000 people.
You've heard about that.
Yeah.
Let's start at the very, very top. And let's do a show where the top, you know, music artists in the world perform. In one of the biggest venues, and certainly the biggest venue in LA.
Yeah. So how come it took 3 years?
Because everybody thought we were insane. You know, everybody thought we were completely crazy, and it took that long to not only to get all of the rights and licenses.
But
to create the videos, and actually we had to create technology because what we wanted to do had never been done before, with a live symphony completely synchronized to video, also synchronized with special effects and rock and roll lighting and interactive elements where we change the music on the fly depending on what people are doing on stage and things like that. So we had to create this thing that has never existed before. So that's why it took so long, and it's freaking expensive. I mean, we had to save up some money, man. Shoot. I mean, if you can imagine me, you know, calling a company like Taito and saying, I'd like to, I'm going to be performing the music to Elevator Action on the Hollywood Bowl with 200 musicians from the LA Philharmonic. Hello? They hung up on me.
How do you get involved with VGL? Did Tommy and Jack just call you one day and like,
Actually, it was a long story, but there was a conference in the States, and it's called the Game Developers Conference. And I made a speech, and Tommy loved it, and we became friends. And he invited me to some concerts, not only in the States, but in like Brazil and Tokyo.
You're also on the Metal Gear series.
Yeah.
It kind of reminds me of, you know, Jerry Bruckheimer and Michael Bay kind of movies.
Oh, thank you.
And even like Snake Eater. That sounds like a James Bond theme.
Oh yeah.
So, are you influenced by movie soundtracks, or do you try to move away from movie soundtracks?
In the beginning, the producer Mr. Kojima, he required me to listen to a lot of the Hollywood movie soundtrack.
Okay.
And that was quite a big influence.
But initially, yeah.
Yeah, initially, yeah. But as the series goes on, and I try to develop on my own, because I came from the jazz background.
Yeah, I get your jazz influence.
So.
On a more personal level, how do you go from like a jazz performer to a video games composer? That's like a huge leap there.
But that was thanks to PlayStation 2, actually.
Oh,
it was like 1999, and I got into Konami, and that was the time the video game sound changed from kind of like synthesizer
music.
To orchestral music.
Everyone loves it. It doesn't matter what age you are, it doesn't matter if you play games. We built this show for everybody.
They might think that video game music's a bunch of bleeps and bloops. You know, the orchestra's gonna be plucking bleep, bloop, bleep, bloop all night long. What the hell's that gonna sound like, you know? And so I challenge those people and to come to the show. And that's the thing that blows people away the most. In fact, the most letters and emails that we get after a performance aren't from the gamers, believe it or not. The most emails we get are from the non-gamers. Thank you for opening my eyes to a whole new world that I didn't really even knew existed. You know?
It's like a boon to like all gamer girlfriends or wives.
Exactly.
In the world.
Exactly. Bring your girlfriends tomorrow.
So what does your wife and kids think about VGL?
Oh, they love it.
Do they come on tour with you guys?
They do, and both of them sing. So my daughter Gracie, she's 13 years old. She sings in the show. My wife Cindy, she sings in the show.
Cool.
Both really super talented. They're a very musical family. Yeah. So yeah, it's been a lot of fun. We've seen a lot of the world together, so it's been great.
Cool. Yeah. I read on the website that you guys have a set of 60s. Type of different.
Yeah, we have about 60 different segments that we have in the show.
And we're only going to see 20 segments here in KL.
Correct. That's right.
So there's a possibility that you guys will come down to KL with another 20 further down the line?
Yeah, we'll come down back next year and play a different show.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Rock on.
All right.
Thanks.